In this vlog, we are going to implement video player in your Flutter application, and this will be the very easiest way to implement video player in your Flutter application. So I suggest you to watch this tutorial till the end. So here we are going to create a class using which you can play videos in your Flutter application. So this particular class will be very much handy for you. You can play videos anywhere in your Flutter application by making use of this particular class. So I suggest you to create this particular class and add it to your project, with which you can play the videos very easily, and also you can customize this particular class according to your requirement. So let's get started with adding dependencies here. So here I am making use of a CV dependency and a video player. So by making use of these two dependencies, we are going to customize our video player here. So in our previous tutorials, we have covered video player using better player dependency. So you may go through this particular tutorial. I am providing the link in the description section below. And in this part of the tutorial, I want to make it much easier for you by creating a separate class and making use of it in your project. So as we have added these two particular dependencies, let's try to import them as well in our code. So here, whenever you start typing the dependency name, you will be getting the import here. So these are the two imports, and also we have a regular import which we make use of in our Flutter application, like material.dart here. And also let's try to import video player which we have added here. So this particular video player will provide us the features of fetching the video source. So for example, whenever you're trying to play a video from a network, that is a URL is provided. So from the URL you are trying to fetch the video and you are going to play, or you can just play a video from assets folder. So we'll be seeing more in our tutorial. So now let's get started. As I have said, we are going to create a class. So here we don't require a void main. So this is an individual class, and I'm going to consider stateful widget for it. So STF, when you start typing it, you can just get a suggestion like you're going to create a stateful widget. Okay. And now I'm going to name this particular class like video player widget, and you can just rename it accordingly as per your requirement. So here we have got our stateful widget, and now let's get started with our coding. So the very first thing is we are going to create a video player controller here. So video player controller, I'm going to declare a variable for it. And the next thing is, do we require looping? So a final boolean variable stating looping. And even we can just remove the let here, because we are going to initialize them with the help of a constructor here. And final boolean variable for autoplay. So what is autoplay and looping here is like, whenever you want to repeat the video, once the video is completed, then it comes under looping. And the very first time when you load your application without tapping on the play button, if you want to start the video automatically, then it's like an autoplay. So these are the general terminologies. So now with the help of a constructor here, let's try to initialize these objects here. So this dot video player controller comma this dot looping this dot autoplay. Okay, so now here we have got these three objects now, and you can add few more objects here. These are the basic things which I'm going to explain you, and also I will show you how you can add few more objects according to your requirements. So these are the basic requirements which I have added for now. So now let's also specify our CV controller here, using which we can control the video flow. And now let's try to initialize it with the help of init state here. So in the init state, let's specify our CV controller and provide our requirements here. And here you can observe we are getting an error here. We have specified our video player controller here and we are not able to access it. So if you have gone through our previous tutorials also, I have explained you there to make use of the objects which you have specified here. You need to specify widget dot so that it will parse the object. And now I am also going to specify the aspect ratio here. And for now I'm just going to specify it's like 4:9. Yes, generally aspect ratios are specified with the ratio symbol here, but now in Chivi here you need to specify like 4:9, which is same of course. And auto initialize, so initializing thing, so I'm just specifying it as true here. And now auto play here, so we have also fetched the information from user like for autoplay. So again with the help of widget here you can get the autoplay, this boolean variable which we have declared here. And the next thing what we got is like looping, and also specify it over here, looping widget dot looping. So what we are just trying to do is like we are trying to assign the values which we have got from the user. So whenever you're trying to make use of this particular class, you need to provide these particular values to this particular class, right? So we are just going to assign them to our player. And now I think you understood what we are trying to use in this particular class and what we are going to fetch the output out of this particular class. And if you're still having any queries, just let me know in the comment section below. I will try to explain you again. And now let's also specify an error builder so that we can handle the error scenarios as well. So specify the context here and also error message. And this is again how you want to specify your error message return. And I just want my error message to be displayed in the center of the screen. And in center, let's specify a text widget and something like, okay, something went wrong, or you can just specify specifically what error you have got here and add semicolons here. And also we have got init state here. Let's try to dispose them properly after the usage. So we need to dispose our Chivi controller as well after usage. Okay, so this is a must thing to avoid the memory leaks in our application. And now within the container, let's specify our child, which is nothing but Chivi here, and inside which specify the controller which we have just created. Okay, so this is that simple how we create a class file using which you can play videos in your Flutter application. So here I just forgot to specify a semicolon which is showing an error here. A function body must be provided. Okay, so let's add the semicolon here. And yes, this is the class which I am trying to show you by using which we can play videos in our Flutter application. So yes, this is it for this tutorial, and I just wanted to make it simple, so I have just explained you the creation of class in this particular tutorial. And in the next tutorial I am going to show you how to make use of this particular class and play videos in your Flutter application. And I suggest you to just make a try, like how to use this particular class and play videos, and just let me know in the comment section below if you are successful. And stay subscribed to our channel for the next tutorial where we are going to show you how to make use of this particular class and play videos. And there we are going to make use of a video URL, and also we are going to play a video from the local assets. So the code for this tutorial is provided in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.